Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you sequence number and acknowledgement number in TCP segment header. There can be so many questions that could come in competitive as well as in university examination based on sequence number and acknowledgement number. Like there can be a first question, why there is a need of acknowledgement number in TCP segment header. There can be second question, like how we have sequence number and acknowledgement number in TCP segment header, as well as how to identify acknowledgement number in TCP segment header. There can be question like why there is a need of randomness in sequence number at start, as well as there can be question based on what is wrap around in sequence number. So I'll explain you all those points in great details along with practical examples. Let us try to understand first why there is a need of acknowledgement number. There can be question like why there is a need of acknowledgement number. Let me explain you why. If you observe computer network, then in computer network, see internet protocol that is working at network layer. And see on computer network, when transmitter and receiver is communicating with each other, at that time that communication happens via frames. That communication happens via frames. And this transmitter is not having an idea about whether this frame is received by receiver or not, right? See, transmitter is simply forwarding frames on computer network. Transmitter is not having idea about whether this frame is received over here. Why? The reason is in internet protocol, there is no such functionalities like acknowledgement. We have studied IPv4 and IPv6. Those are internet protocol, which is working in network layer. So here at network layer, in internet protocol, there is no such functionalities like acknowledgement. That's why internet protocol service is unreliable, right? And to make it reliable, in transport layer, we have TCP. And in TCP, we have acknowledgement number. Here, by acknowledgement, transmitter will be having an idea about, okay, frame is received by receiver. So first of all, you should know, see, to make internet protocol reliable, here we have TCP, which is connection oriented service, in which we are providing communication with acknowledgement, which makes your services reliable, right? So first of all, you should be having an idea about like why acknowledgement number is required. Acknowledgement number that is required for reliable services, right? Now there can be second question like what is the need of sequence number? So if you observe here, see session layer output is data. That is given to transport layer. In transport layer, we have TCP, which will be generating segments. So here we have data that we are bisecting into segments. So with segments, we are having data, right? But that we are bisecting over here. That's why we provide sequence number. Let me explain you how it is provided. See, here, for example, if I say we are having frame over here, right? We are having frame over here. And in that, see here, IP header will be there. IP header will be there, and then there will be TCP header, right? And then there will be data. Now, if you observe, see IP header. So IP header is having identification number that explains numbering of packet. So IP header is having identification number that explains numbering of packet. TCP header is having sequence number. TCP header that is having sequence number, right? And that sequence number explains what? Byte stream means what is the first location of byte in data. Like you see here, we are having data, we are bisecting that into segments. So what will be first location, what will be first location over here with given data? That is explained by sequence number. The reason is large data that we are not forwarding on computer network, large data that we are bisecting into segments. So with each segment, what is the location of first byte? That is indicated by sequence number, right? And why there is a need of acknowledgement? The reason is internet protocol is unreliable service. To make it reliable, we are having acknowledgement number. Now I'm going to explain you how sequence number and acknowledgement number is there. You should know sequence number and acknowledgement number that is having size of 32 bits, right? Now see, here we are having one segment, and that segment corresponds to data. Along with that, there will be TCP header and there will be IP header, right? In packet, this is segment. TCP header plus data, that is segment. Here you see complete format is there with TCP header. This complete format, that is TCP header. After that, there will be data, right? So here, sequence number and 32 sequence number and acknowledgement number, that will be there inside TCP header, that is having size of 32 bits. Here, see, sequence number corresponds to first byte in the given segment. Let me explain you how. Let us say source and destination is communicating with each other via network socket. In my last video, I have explained you what is network socket. Network socket is IP plus port. So network socket explains how process to process communication happens. Why? Right. IP means internet protocol address, that explains you logical addressing, and port number, that explains you process number. Right. So here process to process communication, that happens as per network socket. So here source and destination is having network socket as per IP plus port. IP plus port, it is mentioned over here. Let us say source is forwarding one frame. Let us say source is forwarding one frame, and with this frame, you should know we are having header and data. Now this data's first byte, that will be sequence number. Let us say it is 0 initial. So if it is 0, then see, this segment is having sequence number, that explains first byte location, that is 0 right now. Means in complete data, let us say this is my complete data. Here we have 0, 1, 2, 3, up to some number will be there, right? Let us say 1024. So first data number, that is this right now, that is 0. So that is assigned over here in first segment by 0 as per sequence number. Now let us say here we are forwarding 0 to 199 byte, means 200 bytes that we are forwarding. So sequence number will be 0 over here. Now when you forward next segment, so in that also you will be having header and data. In that also sequence number will be there. So here sequence number should be 200. Why? The reason is up to 199 we have forwarded the data. So now next byte number, that should be 200 over here. So that will be sequence number. So here from 200 onwards, data will be there, and that data, let us say it is going up to 399. And now let us consider both of these segments, that has been received by destination. So here destination is giving acknowledgement. Destination is giving acknowledgement. Now in acknowledgement, there will be header as well as data. Now in that, you will have to see how acknowledgement number is there, right? So what should be acknowledgement number? See, destination have received up to 0 to 399 byte. So obviously destination will be asking for which byte number? 399 plus 1 means 400. So acknowledgement number, that will be 400 over here, right? So here, see, acknowledgement number calculation, that is done at destination side. It will be giving acknowledgement here, in which acknowledgement number gives idea about what should be the number of byte that source should forward in next segment, right? So whenever source is forwarding next segment, at that time what should be the location of data byte, right? So that is how acknowledgement number is there. But practically, if destination is calculating all those things, then it will be too much time consuming. And even you need to understand one thing. See, here in TCP segment header, we are having data offset. That explains what? That explains header length. This data offset, that explains header length. So here we are not having length of data in TCP segment header. Remember this. We are not having idea about what is the length of data with given segment. Whatever segment that we forward, that could be having any length. But that identification is not given in TCP segment header. Here only header length, that is given over here, right? So as header length is given, see, numbering is very essential as per sequence number. Now you might be having question like, how to identify acknowledgement number? See, sequence number identification, that you can understand based on, see, first byte reference. Like if it is 0 and if it is transmitting from 0 to 199, next sequence number should be 200. Simply we can calculate it like that, right? But how to calculate acknowledgement number? So for that, you need to understand one thing. See, sequence number, let us say here we are having sequence number 200. So 200 plus data length, 200 plus data length plus 1, that should be acknowledgement number. See how acknowledgement number should be there. Acknowledgement number, that should be sequence number, right? That should be sequence number plus data length plus data length plus 1, right? Acknowledgement number, that should be sequence number plus data length plus 1. But how to identify data length? Data length field that is not given in TCP header. It is not given over here. So how to identify it? So you should know, my dear students, I have explained you IP protocol, internet protocol. So in internet protocol, we have seen how packet length is there. Like in IP header, we were been having concept which was offset, and that was explaining what is the length of given packet, right? So as per that, we can identify this. How, you see? This is what total packet length that is given inside IP header, right? So sequence number plus packet length minus IP header length minus TCP header length plus 1, that is acknowledgement number. See, acknowledgement number, that should be sequence number plus data plus 1. See here, whatever data that is there with us, plus 1 plus sequence number, that is acknowledgement number. But how to identify data length? Data length will be as per packet length, which is indicated by IP header, minus IP header minus TCP header, that will be data length, right? So that is how we can identify this data length. So you can say acknowledgement number, that is sequence number plus IP packet length, which will be indicated inside IP header, minus IP header length minus TCP header length plus 1. So that is how it is coming, right? Now there are a few basic things that you need to understand. Like, there has to have random sequence number at start. Now you might be having question like, why there has to have random sequence number at start? Let me explain you by one practical case study. Like, you see here, for example, I am forwarding one frame, right? And with this frame, let us say sequence number is 0. Now let us forward another frame which is having sequence number 200, and let us forward another frame which is having sequence number 400 over here. Let us say destination is receiving those things in sequence, but see, this second segment that is received over here by some delay, this second segment that is received here, right? And if you observe here, I have drawn one dashed line over here where connection closed is there. Like, for example, you are using one application, and in between somewhere you are just closing that application, right? So connection close will happen. Now again, you are immediately you are reopening that application. So in that situation, what will happen? As if this frame is received here by some delay, then there can be some confusion. Like if you observe here, first frame, if I say that is starting from sequence number 0, and now let us say next frame that is having sequence number 200 over here. But if you observe here, this frame that is received here by some delay, so here false reception is happening, right? Here false reception is happening. The reason is this frame belongs to previous reception. And you should know, my dear students, whenever you talk about this IP socket, then IP address will not change with source and destination with every communication. As well as there is a possibility that you will be using same port address. For example, if you talk about web browser, then for web browser, port number will not change. It will be same, right? So because of this two addresses, which is network socket that is same, after connection closed, if you receive this frame by some delay, there can be false reception. And to avoid this false reception, what we are doing is we are starting sequence number with random sequence number. If you start sequence number with random sequence number, then what will happen? Let us try to understand that. You see, randomly, let us say we are starting from 1200. Then we are forwarding 1400 here. Then we are forwarding 1800 over here, right? Now you see here, randomly we are starting from 600, right? And then see, after 600, you will not be waiting for 400 over here. you will not be waiting for 1400 here, right? Even if you receive this over here, it will discard it. Why? The reason is, after 600, it will be waiting for 800, right? So whenever you initiate communication at that time, sequence number that should start with random number. And if it is happening like this, in that case, confusion probability that will decrease. So always remember, sequence number initiation that will happen randomly, with means with first segment, random sequence number that is getting generated. And obviously, sequence number is having how much size? 32 bits. So range will be there from 0 to 2 to the power 32 minus 1, right? So out of this range, any single number that is getting selected randomly first, that is practically happening in computer network. Why? The reason is to avoid this kind of confusion, right? Now there is one more fundamental that is quite interesting and essential that you should know, like wrap around in sequence number. See, wrap around, that is very, very essential and that is highly required. Let me explain you why. See, here in computer network, if you observe this layer wise connection, then this is what data which we are translating into segments. Now it is highly possible that this data may be very large. Like when you talk about video, then in video you may have data size which may be greater than 4 GB. See, here sequence number, see, sequence number size is 32 bits. So as per 32 bits, what will be the maximum range of bytes? 2 to the power 32. 2 to the power 32 means 4 GB. So maximum range of bytes as per normal numbering, that is 32 bits. But there can be larger than that size of data in computer network, right? Like, I'm not talking about single frame, I'm talking about so many segments combined together may have complete data size which may be greater than 4 GB. So in that situation, this wraparound that will come into the picture. Now what is wraparound? See, wraparound means, here for example, if you start from sequence number 0, now you are going up to 2 to the power 32. Now again you will be starting from 0, right? Means from here to here you have forwarded about 4 GB data. Now if data size is more than 4 GB, then again you should be able to reuse this numbering from 0, right? And then you should be able to forward it. In that situation, you can say there is a wrap around. Means again you are continuing with same sequence number. Means now you are repeating that number. Like you are starting from 100, for example. Now 102, you are going up to 2 to the power 32 minus 1. Again you are starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 99, and again you are coming to 100. Means from 100 to 100, total size is 4 GB. But if you have size which is greater than 4 GB, then again you will be reusing sequence number in sequence. That is what wrap around. So wrap around is what? It is based on how we are reusing that sequence. So size of sequence number is 32 bits. So as per that, usual sequence number data will be having maximum size, that will be 4 GB as per 2 to the power 32. But due to wraparound, we can start sequence number again. And here wraparound time is the time in which sequence number again starts to repeat, right? So whenever you repeating sequence number from starting onwards, you can say that is what complete time for wraparound. This wraparound time, that is very essential. Based on that, there can be so many questions. So in next video, I'll explain you how there can be question based on wraparound and lifetime. Till if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.